Hey, this is Hector and I'm back with another video tutorial. In today's tutorial, we're going to take a look at how do we do tap tempo in Pro Tools. Now, before we get into how do we do tap tempo, let's just do a quick refresher on what is tempo. Tempo refers to the number of beats per minute, BPM, in your song. So a tempo of 120 would have 120 beats in a minute. So a higher tempo value means a faster song, a faster track, such as a dance track. A slower tempo, such as 90 or 100 beats per minute, would be suitable for a slower song, such as a ballad. So to set up the tempo in Pro Tools by using tap tempo, you have to remember that in Pro Tools, there are two different tempo modes that we can use. We can use the conductor track, which is the session tempo itself, or we can switch over to manual tempo, which the differences between session tempo and the conductor track and manual tempo, we can talk about that in another video tutorial. So I'm just going to show you how it's done in both of the modes. So firstly, let's take a look with the conductor track on. So as you can see that in my transport section over here, you can see that there's this conductor over here, and it's highlighted in blue, which means the conductor track is on, okay? And I also have my tempo ruler showing over here, okay, which you can show it by clicking on this menu icon and ensuring that tempo is selected, okay? So you can see that my current session tempo is 120, okay? So when the conductor track is on, you have to do all your changes in the tempo ruler. So this half a diamond shape, it's actually a diamond shape. Okay, so just double click on that and you get your tempo change. So this is actually a tempo change marker. So you can see that I have 120 beats per minute. I could switch it out to 150. Okay, and just to let you hear that as a change, we're going to create a click track. So create a click track, we're just going to go up to the menu bar where it says track. At the bottom of the menu, it says create click track. Okay, so I have a click track over here now. We're just going to press play. Okay, so that's 150. I can double click that. I can change that back to 120. Okay, so you can hear that 120 is slower than 150. So how do we do tap tempo for this? Okay, I'm just going to double click to bring up the tempo change window again. Okay, now instead of typing in the value, I'm just going to tap the letter T. Okay, T for tempo on my computer keyboard. So I got to tap T. Okay, so this averages about the last eight taps that you have. Okay, so the first couple of taps, it might not register yet. Okay, you might have to tap a couple of times before it averages out the taps. So if I would speed up the tapping on the T key on my computer keyboard, okay, you'll see the tempo go up. And if I slow it down, okay, so make sure you just tap approximately about eight times or more. Okay, so just tap out maybe two bars, four bars. Okay, just to get a consistent value. Once the value is set, you're good to go. Just hit the enter key to lock it in, and you can see that my tempo has been updated to 95. Okay, so now next thing I'm going to do is we're going to take a look at how to do tap tempo with manual tempo mode. Okay, so I have up here in my toolbar my transport showing already. Okay, but I'm just going to show you out with the standalone transport window. Okay, so that can actually be brought up with the menu bar where it says window. If you go down, you say transport. Okay, the hotkey is command number pad 1 on Mac. Okay, so you can see that I have this transport window over here. Now, this is the section that we actually want, which is classified under MIDI controls. Okay, so you might get a window that looks something like that. Okay, you always see the play buttons. Okay, and you might not see where the tempo section is. So I'm just going to show you how it's done. Okay, just clicking on this drop-down menu and it says MIDI controls. Okay, and it can show up over here. This is the section that we're concerned about. Okay, we're not going to worry about the other ones. We can do that in another video. Okay, so same thing as mentioned early on. You can see that they are identical. Okay, so up here, same controls. Okay, so I'm just going to show you on the standalone floating window over here, just for the people who use this, okay? So the conductor track itself, okay, when it's on, you'll notice that the tempo is white in color. And I can't actually change this, so I'm just clicking this many times. I can't change anything, okay? So I'm just turning off the conductor track, and you'll notice that the tempo value turns green, okay? And in the tempo ruler, it starts saying manual tempo now. So this is manual tempo mode, okay? So the key difference is a manual tempo mode allows you one fixed tempo for the entire session, okay? So with the conductor track, you can actually speed it up or slow it down as the track goes along, okay? And I'll show you how that's done in a separate video. Okay, today we're just gonna focus on tap tempo. So the tempo now is turned green. I can double click on it and highlight it, okay? And I can type in a new value if I want to. But same thing, what we hear about is tap tempo. So I'm gonna click on it and I'm gonna tap the T key again. Okay, so the first two or three taps, nothing really happens. Okay, I'm just tapping at a very consistent rate now. Okay, so tap at the rate of the beats. So if you have a meter of 4/4, okay, just tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, if you want the tempo to go, if you have a fast track, it might go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so just tap on that. Now, the biggest mistake that a lot of people make is forgetting to lock this value in. Okay, so you can see that up here, it says 214, and my manual tempo still says 160. So you actually have to hit the return key once, okay, to lock that in, okay? A common mistake is to tap and then forget about it and go somewhere else. So notice that my value is no longer selected. It says 327, but up here in the tempo ruler, it still says 214, which means that this value of 327, which is ridiculously fast, isn't actually my current tempo, okay? So you have to hit enter once and you will see the manual tempo value in the tempo ruler gets updated to 327, okay? So that's the biggest mistake that most people make. So I'm just gonna tap at a more regular pace, okay? And then hit the return key or the enter key just to lock that value in, okay? So that's how we change the tempo of our tracks. I'm just gonna introduce to you changing of the meter as well. So just right above here, you can see the meter I have now, it's currently 4/4. So you can actually click on that and you can change the meters to be 3/4. Okay, you can also change the subdivision of the beats itself, whether you're quarter notes, which is the most common one that we use, okay, in most pop music. Okay, if you do need to, you could switch it to a half note or eighth note method of counting the tempo itself. Okay, but for majority of your tracks, you're going to be working on a quarter note subdivision. Okay, then that's it. All right, I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Please do subscribe if you wish to get notified when I release the next video. Okay, do give a like if you wish to. And leave a comment below if you have any questions or you just like to say something. And I'll try to reply to all the comments. Thank you and have a great day.